There's number 46 on the season, a Broadway bomb. And oh, okay. That's a new one for us. Where you go from 3-0 to 6-0. Whoa, oh, we're going to play some Leapfrog. I love it. Hello, everyone. I'm SGU, and I'm back with Joe Broadway and his road to the show here today. Yeah, still getting used to that brand new haircut of his. I guess I will get there sooner or later. But you know what? Regardless of what I think about his hairstyle choice, it should not affect how we play on the field, which needs to improve, by the way. We're 40 and 50, 101 RBI, and 45 home runs for Joe, and we are not yet at the All-Star break. Those are some very lofty paces that he is on right now. This ball is going to be hit to left field, and we have a hit, and we might have extra bases. We do. Runner coming home trying to score. He gets around that tag. Two runs score on the play. I believe this will be scored as a double. Do we get to see a replay? I'm not exactly sure what happened out in the outfield, but we will find out together. Ball hit deep down the line. Oh, yeah, it hits the very top of the wall. Almost had his 46th home run of the season. Just, oh, so close to getting over that yellow line and over the fence. So with two runs already home in the inning, Broadway trying to catch him napping and steal third base. That's exactly what he does. What does he think? He's Skeeter Rabbit out there? I don't know, but stealing third base is not something I typically attribute to Joe Broadway's skill set, but he did it right there, and it's going to pay off as this ball hits the center field and should allow him to score, tagging up on the sacrifice fly, 3-0 New York Yankees. Good start for the ball club today. Let's see how things pan out as we go further into the game, however. Will Cleveland get on the board by the time we have another at-bat? Let's find out what our score is. No, it's still 3-0. You have two runners on. You have Broadway at the plate. He hits it deep to right, throws that bat away as if he knows it's gone, because it is gone. There's number 46 on the season, a Broadway bomb. And oh, okay. That's a new one for us. Crazy little dance at second base. We've just doubled our lead with the three-run homer. You go from 3-0 to 6-0. Whoa, oh, we're going to play some Leapfrog. I love it. So creative coming around here. Never know what exactly we're going to get. Well, until we see it, and then it repeats for a while, and then we change it. But I didn't know the Leapfrog was coming. That's pretty cool. Let's see what we've got here on the replay as this ball is going to go out to right field. And, yep, way back in, about halfway back in the bleachers there in right. So Cleveland scores two. It's now 6-2. But that is going to be an out. Joe Broadway thrown across the diamond to get the man at first. So we're 2-for-2 with a home run and a double. 5 RBI. That's the story right there. He has driven in 5 runs already. He's faking a bunt as if anybody believes that's going to happen. But the 3-0 pitch is ruled the ball, and he's going to take his base. You could say they pitched him very cautiously without actually intentionally walking him. They weren't going to give him anything real good to hit. So he takes the walk. This one is going to be hit to right field. It is back. It is deep. It is also gone. 8-2 now. The Yankees came slugging today, hoping to take out the Indians, and they are on their way to doing just that at this point in the ballgame. A 6-run lead once again. This goes 353 feet. Not a terribly long home run, but it clears the fence, and they all count just the same. So officially 2-for-2 still, because he walked in his last at bat, got on base for that home run. It's 9-2 right now in favor of the Yankees. Hot smash to third base, but that liner is gloved, and Broadway is robbed of another potential hit. It's okay. We'll get another shot at it. It's 11-3 now, top of the seventh. The Yankees like a runaway train today. That's a barehanded play. That's a very nice play. Tip your hat to the third baseman right there. One third baseman gets robbed by another as he makes the barehanded throw, the only play he could make. Yankees win the game. And it looks like they won it handily, unless there was a big-time comeback. Oh, well, there was actually. 11-9. They do hang on. That should never have gotten that close. My goodness. Bullpen, what are you doing? Anyway, next game out. Back to Progressive Field. Now we're just 9 games below 500. Indians 8 games above 500. Broadway added 5 more RBI to that total yesterday, bringing it up to 106 entering play. crazy how he is driving in runs, a lot of it coming with home runs. There's another smash to third base. There's another line drive that's going to be caught. Had one of those in the last game as well. It's okay. You're hitting the ball hard. That's a good sign. So you just got to get that elevation a little bit, that launch angle, and we'll have it in the seats in no time. Here at third base, he's got a chance to make his own play on a liner, and he does just that. Doesn't have to move very much, but just make sure the reflexes are good. Goes on over to third, just in case that runner had any ideas of stranding, but he stayed right at the bag, very smartly so. 2-1 Yankees now, and a 2-1 count to the batter, Joe Broadway, and this is hit to left center. And it's going to be down for a hit. And it's going to go in the gap. And it's going to go to the wall. And he's going to go to second base, and he will be safe. Joe Broadway, extra base hit. Nobody out, and he is now in scoring position. You see he's trailing only Bernie Berry in the doubles category. Good alliteration going on that name. That almost sounds like a character that I would create for Road to the Show. There's a ground out, but also a run coming home. It's 3-1 Yankees. Productive outs. That's what we like to see. All right. So we won game one. We're working on game two. Where are we at the next time we come to bat? Well, we've had a double. We've got another run on the board. It's now 4-1. Three-run lead. You got a runner on. You got two outs. You got Joe Broadway swinging for the downs. And he connected. Broadway bomb. Number 47. Beating the chest there. Pounding the chest as he comes around second base. He's the man, and he knows it. He's looking to break his own single-season home run record this year. Oh, okay, that's a different handshake, high-five combo. I like it. What do we got at home plate? Anything special? Nah. Just a bash and then a low five. Whatever. It's awesome. Broadway has homered again. I don't think this Cleveland crowd thinks it's too awesome. But you know what? They're going to have to live with it because sluggers are going to slug and Broadway is going to bomb. There you go. Hits another one. Okay. Can he make it a multiple home run game? He's got two hits and it's 6-1 and there are two outs and there's nobody on and third baseman's not going to be able to take that one away from him. It is a hit out to left. Three-hit game for Broadway. Things looking good in this one for not only him, but for the team. You know, you got to get some winning streaks going if you want to dig out of a spot that they've put them in early in the season, you know. Constantly below 500 and just kind of toiling there. They got to put a run together at some point where they rattle off 8, 9, 10 wins in a row, and then we can start talking about contention. That ball is a very nice play to field it and throw over to first base to end the inning. The Indians could have allowed more if it were not for the good defense right there. Oh, but here they come right back. It's 7-5. We've got the bases loaded. How about a grand slam? No. Hot smash to third. He's playing in a little bit. Fields it, throws home. They get the out there. They then throw to first to complete a double play. Not what Broadway was hoping to come up with the bases loaded and nobody out. They did not score a run. That's okay. The Yankees win the game. Yankees win and get to celebrate yet again. Second straight game. That feels good indeed. So as this thing wraps up and the Indians kind of dejectedly head to their clubhouse after not being able to secure a win for the second straight day, you see 7-5 was the final. And we'll check in what's going on with Mr. Broadway after the game. He of a double, a home run, and a single in this game, only a triple short of the cycle. We end up sweeping that series in Cleveland and winning 2 of 3 against Toronto at home. Next up will be the Angels coming to town, and you see the Yankees are in third place now and only a mere 16 and a half games out of first place. Ouch. Yeah, there is a lot of work to be done. Speaking of work being done, how about the all-star balloting? Joe Broadway putting in work there as he's leading all third basemen in the American League, and he's pretty much lapping Manny Machado there, almost double the votes. So Angels up next. That'll be the last series we have before the all-star break, and I mean, clearly we're going to see a home run derby and an all-star game appearance coming up for this guy. He is crushing it. Come on back next time for more Broadway bombs and Joe Broadway.